All right, hydrangeas, if you haven't heard, or if I'm sure you've seen, they're having an era right now.
They are. They're having a peak.
Right?
They're peaking everywhere.
They are peaking.
Yeah, but I want to know what you do this year to make sure that they come back and bloom just like they did this year, next year. Mm. Sarah Bailey is here, our master gardener. And you tell us that hydrangeas are pretty much past their... This is it.
This was beautiful 2 weeks ago.
It was stunning because I kept looking outside.
Some of them still are.
Right.
I mean, every plant's a little bit different.
Yeah.
But this is past its prime. And like those of us who are past our prime, they're not looking their best.
Are you talking about my back?
No, I'm talking about me.
No, you guys are all beautiful. Just a little bit of fertilizer, guys. Let's
exactly.
Push it right up.
So in this case, I mean, there's still some lovely blossoms over on the other side.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, it's had its moment in the sun, literally, and now it's saying, okay, it's time to rest.
So this is like a Terry Jackson song. We've had joy, we've had fun, we've had seasons in the sun.
That's a great song. That's a great classic. Little vinyl vault there, hidden. All right, do we have to cut these back or prune while we still have some blooms?
Well, one of the things, nice things about hydrangeas is that you generally don't have to prune them for size, as long as you put them in the right place to begin with. I've seen this plant now for 2 or 3 years. I know it doesn't get pruned here, and it's been the same size every year.
Okay.
There are lots of different hydrangeas. Pruning's different on a lot of them. We're going to talk about the hydrangea macrophylla, which is what this one is, the big leaf hydrangea, because this is the one everybody talks about, and this is the one that's spectacular this year. These bloom on what's called old wood. They set their buds this year for next year.
Oh.
Really?
Yes. So if you do a hard prune on this thing after, you know, in 2, 3, 4 weeks, you're starting to take off next year's buds.
Oh, that's not good.
We don't want to do that.
Biggest mistake that gets done. But in the same way, you said, how I'm going to tell you how to make them look as good next year as they do this year. I don't control that.
Oh.
Mother Nature does.
Okay.
These guys look spectacular this year because we did not have that May frost that we so routinely have.
Okay.
The plant is hardy to our zone. The buds are not necessarily.
Okay.
You live farther south in the state, you are more likely to have great blooms every year because it's a little bit warmer down there. Up here, we get that spotty bloom, a little bit of flower here, a little bit of flower there. Some years they look great, some years they don't, but it's all dependent on whether those buds survive the frost.
Wow. Now, so don't clip anything back.
Well, you're gonna clip some stuff back if you want it to look good. So let's take this one. It's over, it's done. We're
going
to clip it back right to the first joint.
Okay.
And out.
That's
and
it.
Out it goes.
That's all you're going to do.
So this one here would get clipped back to the joint over there.
Matter of fact,
which
it's going to break off on its own.
Well,
same
you don't have clippers.
You're going to take it back to about here.
Okay.
And clip it off. That leaves all of this stem to set buds for next year.
And so that one you clipped right at the bottom, right?
Yeah, right. It's kind of the first set of leaves.
Okay. Gotcha.
And again, that sets the stage for the planting the blooms for next year.
Correct, for setting the blooms for next year.
And it won't get bigger than that, even though
a little bit, but not
horrendous.
Huge.
What was it you were saying? Hydrangea phylla,
macrophylla, large leaf.
Because I have some ointment for that if you're trying to get rid of it.
So there are a whole bunch of different. I mean, a lot of people know the white hydrangeas, the kind of almost the old tree, the big shrub.
Yeah.
That's a panicle hydrangea. That's a different cousin.
Different species.
They bloom on new wood.
Oh.
So that's why those reliably bloom every year. The buds are set in the spring, and you get that spectacular bloom. They're white.
Right.
They're never going to be blue. They're never going to be pink.
Are those the limelights, or is that different?
Limelight is in that same group, yes.
Okay, because, what about pruning limelights? Right now I have some really tall limelights, but then I have just greenery on the bottom.
Those you can prune any time because, again, they bloom on new wood.
Okay.
So one of the good ideas is to go in every couple of years, take out some of what's here, not so much for height, but it's starting to get kind of thick and full in here.
Yeah.
Thin it out a little bit.
Okay.
And then let new growth come in.
Sarah, where can we get in touch with you if you have any questions?
That's the UConn Extension. I'm with the Hartford office, UConn Master Gardeners at hartford.edu.
I'd like to give this to you. It's not almost dead.
I'd like to give this to you.
Well, thank you. This is what I need.
Have a great day. Thank you, Sarah.
My pleasure.